Now, I call upon Professor Shiv Gaonkar. I hope the by the time Professor Desi Raju's mic and all that would be okay. Professor Shiv Gaonkar.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you, Professor Khandal. Namaskar. I think it was on your invite that I could come for this seminar.
Thank you, sir.
Before me, there are three eminent speakers have already talked about the higher education. The AICT chairman, Professor Sahasrabuddhe, Professor K.K. Agrawal, who was the chairman of MGA, and Professor P.B. Sharma, who are the senior most vice chancellor. You know, we all respect all three people who expressed the views actually before me. Well, what I'm going to talk about is not only engineering education, but the higher education per se. And actually, this talk is not only after post-COVID. This thinking has been there for even before that, even in last AIU meeting, which was held in Katra. Some of the ideas actually have floated that what has happened in last 100 years and in the transformation which has taken place in the world. And today, education system really look, if you look at, are we really moving into the right direction? So it is not only the sustenance of the institutions only. Bigger question is that are we really moving into the right direction, and what is the role of universities in this movement, right? Moving into the future. So these are some of the general issues essentially I'm going to talk about. So just let me ask some very few basic fundamental questions. You know, when you look at the higher education, so there were certain classical objectives which were defined for higher education. And these objectives were creation of dissemination of knowledge, search for truth, achieve higher order cognitive skills, develop critical thinking, challenge prejudices, opportunity to dive deep into your passion, prepare for earning livelihood, develop value system, create humans of higher ethical and intellect capability. These were actually the original objectives which used to define what a higher education system or a university should be. However, if you look at today, what has happened to higher education system, the higher education system essentially has become only the professional education. That's what has gained the importance. In fact, there are many liberal arts education and all that actually has got backseat if you really look at this point of time. And education also has become more market driven. So whatever markets are requiring, I think everybody is getting aligned to that, and the whole education system is getting steered, which is why market-driven forces. Technology also started defining the educational paradigm. Now, I am definitely a great supporter of technology, but technology only we should understand it is a tool. Technology should not dictate what you should be doing. We should first define what you want to do, and technology only should support what we want to do, and technology should essentially help that. Employability became a prime focus. So today you take any program, the first question students, parents, everybody ask is the employability. As if the employability is the only soul of getting higher education. And so getting employability certainly is one of the factors, but certainly it cannot be the factor to decide which program you should get into. Secondly, the thing has happened, it has become a student-centric system. Now the student-centric system is very well appreciated, provided the students are motivated. And you will see there are a large number of students in our society not self-motivated. And those people who are sitting on the fence, this student-centric system doesn't really drive them to the capabilities which they should be actually acquiring. And this has impacted actually the social fabric irreversibly. If you really look at what happened to education system in the last 50, 60 years, I think we have really changed our social fabrics in view of that. So if you look at what is a market-driven society, and if you are going to prepare our students for that, you will see that first of all, the market-driven society has created a fair amount of disparity into the society. And you will see that this disparity actually is continuing to grow. Even digital empowerment, what we say, it is also creating class of people who are digitally affluent and who are non-digitally affluent. So the disparity society is getting. Second thing, what has happened in last 100 years, there is a significant degradation of the environment. which has taken place, because this whole market-driven society, it has really started consuming the resources, natural resources, and it has become very clear now that whatever path we have defined for our growth, this path is not a sustainable path. So today, when you are having a society which is a digitally connected society, where everybody knows in what is happening in every part of the other part of the world, this connected world, disparity is not a very good thing. And this creates essentially a unstable society. The stability of the society gets disturbed in this connection. That is the scenario which we are having. So sustainability, if you look at, you will see that there are predictions by the world organizations. It says in next 50-60 years, your population will increase by 50%. Your energy requirement will increase by 100%. Your electricity requirement will increase by 300%. Natural resources will reduce by 90%, 80 to 90%. Food requirement will increase 100%. And water stress population will increase by 200%. Now, this is the scenario which we are heading into. And also, if you really look at, when you look at the education system and our society, we should also be looking at that, are we really creating a society or a development which has many other features which are an integral part of any happy society? So, for example, well-being, prosperity, happiness, health, is it really getting really a front seat when we talk about the development? Time affluence, are people so busy that they don't have any time to really enjoy the life and be happy in life? Community cohesion, are people really creating a cohesive society, or people are getting segregated into their pockets? Is environmental getting really damaged significantly? So are we protecting the ecosystem? Whatever growth we are talking about, is it sustainable? These are the questions one should ask when we talk about the higher education system. So having this scenario and the development which has taken place in the last 50-60 years, and next 50-60 years, we are going to be very resource crunch world. The question one can ask is, what is the role of university? So invariably we talk about, will universities prepare for our use for future? Right? But the question is, which future? Who is going to define what future we want to really get into? And if we want to get really a good future which is sustainable, then humanity should be kept at the center of the entire thing, not the development. And development, if it is some way, if it is not going to support the humanity as a whole, then I think that development also has to be checked in. So the university, my opinion, university should not prepare for future. They should prepare the people who will mold the future. And therefore, the responsibility of any university would be, and technology definitely will play a role. So let me make some observations at this point. So first of all, it is very clear, as has been said by eminent speakers before me, the future world will be technology dominant. Right? This, people were realizing even last 10, 15 years, that technology is definitely going to play a very important role in education. But the COVID has really reasserted this. I mean, you can imagine if today the internet connectivity was not there, the online education was not there, after the 15th of March, after the lockdown started, practically we would have been stranded if this technology was not in place. Because of this technology, we could still continue our classes. Some of the universities, including Bennett, could even conduct the examinations. So disruption was not that much, as the technology was not really there. So it is very clear that the world is definitely going to be technology dominated. Second thing, the future world will be interconnected. And that also we are seeing now, that the most of the technology and thing which we could achieve, it is because of the dominance of the ICT, which is the information and communication technology. And future world is also going to be stress for natural resources, the number which I showed you. That essentially projects on that. So with this in mind, then, if you want to develop an education, the online, of course, is one of the solutions could be there. But what the online education can achieve and what the online education cannot achieve, if you put this bigger perspective for the education. So initially, when I pointed out the thing which higher education defines, you will see that the information transfer, the knowledge transfer, developing maybe some analytical skills, this thing can very well be done by ICT, by using online education. developing logical reasoning, identification of the problem into the real world and translating them into the technology problems. This cannot be done only by the ICT education, online education. You will require a great amount of interaction with the human beings, right? There have to be trained professors, there has to be, you know, the trainers who will interact on this. And together, the technology and the human being, trained human beings, they can really achieve this logical reasoning, identification of problems and solving societal problems. And then in the university education, there are many important aspects which go much beyond the classroom. The development of ethos, the development of character, the holistic vision which we require, what and how to learn, these are the aspects which are not taught directly into any of the classes. And obviously they cannot be done in online mode, because if it cannot be expressed in an exclusive format, then they cannot be captured into online mode. These things have to be inculcated by interaction with the great human beings. That only can happen with the human interaction. So online education will achieve something, but there are many things which is a part of education system which online education will not be able to achieve, and for which you will require really great human beings to be interacting with the young minds. So we require actually a blend, which rightly has been said, that education has to become a blend. Something may come from online, but when we talk their blend, we still think that the blend is only just simple classroom teaching and the online. I think the blend is not only classroom teaching and online. The blend is inculcating the values, right, values from the teachers and the great human beings around you, and the knowledge and the skill transfer. That is the blend which actually we should be looking for. So coming to the post-COVID situation, then some natural question one can ask it. So in my opinion, when we go to university system, what are we producing? Are we producing only the skilled manpower which will go into some industry or some office and will do the job? No, in my opinion, I think the purpose of education is at three levels. First, education system should produce great human beings. Second level, they should be producing great citizens. And third, they should be producing the great professionals. The order has to be in that sequence. This should not be reversed. And if the whole education system steers only about the third point of creating only professionals without giving due importance to the first two, I think the education system will falter someday. So some natural observation one can make post-COVID: will online education produce the right kind of humans? And as I already mentioned, there's something, some skills human can achieve, but in the holistic development, we will require really a face-to-face education and online education. Will the new norm of university evolve? This is a great question. But if I really go by the basic definition of what were the original objectives of university, you will see that the university as such cannot be completely transformed into a new model. You may get some technology inculcated into the system, and some modification may take place, but still you will require the old classical model of university, right? Because university does not do only imparting the knowledge, they also do the creation of knowledge, which is called research. This will not be able to be achieved just by using online mode, because you really require a lot of active interaction with the people and so on. We will create a new paradigm of the society. That again we have to see. But that's where I think universities have to play a role. Whatever society we want to create now, this society has to be sustainable, and it should be with the right paradigm. So when we recover from COVID, my suggestion is, let us not restore at a location where we left before COVID. Let us use this COVID as a reset pulse and ask a question: whatever was the wrong path deviation had happened in last 50, 60 years, can we now correct it using this opportunity of post-COVID and create a new paradigm, right, of the society, which will have all the aspects of happy life?
Thank you, sir.
You know, and so on and so on.
Thank you, sir.
Two, three more points. Yes, I'll close it.
Just close it, sir.
Yeah. So impact of COVID, in my opinion, people talk about the health. I think Professor Sharma also said that. I think what COVID has done, it has done something, in my opinion, something positive. It made people realize what are the true needs of ours. Secondly, it has made unnecessarily travel redundant. People don't have to travel for doing constructive work. Third, efficient use of time. There is a less pollution. There is a less diseases. There are more connect with faculty. There is better ecology. And there is a redefinition of value system and social interaction. So in my opinion, COVID we should look at is a great opportunity which we have got. And in view of that, we should create a new education system for future. And what that education system should be? The need to define the correct path through the new education, which will go beyond the information and skill. Should be good amalgamation of knowledge, skill, value system, sustainability, and happiness. Preservation of culture, geographical, biological, natural diversity. Don't make everything unified in the world. Living in collaboration and cooperation with nature and correcting the path which we traveled over the last few decades, right, over the next 50 years. I'll close at this point and thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Well, very well spoken. Sir, you touched upon the real key issues. The one which is most impressive is about the reset. You know, whenever telephones, etc., we go for factory setting. I think this COVID-19 is the factory setting mode for all of us. The second thing you said is that we should not go back to restore to where we were. I think we have to really change the direction. Disha sahi hogi, tabhi dasha sahi hogi. Aur abhi tak disha theek nahi thi. The very important point that you brought out about the universities is that we have to really create professionals with human values. I think this is very, very important. This is what Professor Sharma also said. And this can be done jointly because knowledge cannot be created unilaterally or one way. It has to be created both ways. The students and the teachers, they have to work together. I think the biggest thing today, sir, jo ye COVID-19 mein hua hai, jo hum baat hi nahi sochte aur karte, COVID-19 ne humko shaharon se wapas gaon mein la diya. तो अब हमारी यूनिवर्सिटी को भी गांव ओरिएंटेड होना चाहिए ना कि शहरों ओरिएंटेड. और जो आपने कहा ट्रैवल नहीं करना है, जो बेकार के काम थे वो अब बिल्कुल बंद कर दे रहे हैं. तो आई थिंक ये रीसेट बटन दबाना पड़ेगा. वी ऑल विल हैव टू गो टू फैक्ट्री सेटिंग ऑफ गॉड. गॉड ने हमारा कुछ सेटिंग किया है. पहले हमारे ऋषि मुनि पहाड़ों में चले जाते थे, 75 ईयर्स के बाद संन्यास ले लेते थे और पूरा परलोक सुधारते थे. परलोक का कॉन्सेप्ट ही खत्म हो गया. अभी आपने कहा अगले 50-60 साल में एनर्जी की रिक्वायरमेंट होगी. क्यों एनर्जी की रिक्वायरमेंट होगी? मनुष्य का काम है सेवा करना. वो एनर्जी क्रिएट करे ना कि एनर्जी एक्सप्लॉइट करे. आपने बहुत अच्छा बोला सर. थैंक यू वेरी मच.